It's been a minute since I've done an update video. Everything that was supposed to be done back in August, so. Just got the call last. It's now Wednesday. Got the call Friday. Last Friday. For the same nonsense as June that I'm supposed to already be taken care of. So, yeah. Luckily, it looks like the season's kind of half holding out. It's getting cold at night, but it kind of warms up during the day. And that's about it. And I knew that the way it was patchworked together already. My check was supposed to show up for a whopping $44 a week lifeline, which I budget off to food and medicine every week. Luckily, I've got hygiene, but I gotta throw another 10 at the damn phone bill. And I have to throw $2.50 to get my kid the nice food out of the dang local Dollar General here. Even though she's been spoiled. Fuck. Tuna, salmon, spam. Oh, she's been spoiled, though. She always gets the pizza, too, of course. I really don't know what to do. I've been trying to find, like, a perfect little spot I could try to build a winter shanty slash shelter. And try to just sit through it. Somewhere that's quiet, I can control the lights, in other words, you know, at this point, the warmth, I know how to do all my crazy, you know, Tao teaching and all this shit, body, energetic, ambient heat, which I wish I could, like, you know, give you a full spectrum camera. Anyway, why the fucking, what is the term in society? Ascended masters don't tend to show off that often. It's kind of a sacred thing. Kind of. You know, under laboratory conditions, the laboratory conditions also have to be set to, you know, no observer effect. Because an observer effect's collapse on what the hypothesis is. Well, for a novice, it would pretty much make nothing happen. Someone like I can measure the direction of the observer effect collapse in the wave function, its direction and distance. It's like DARPA, eat your heart out. So I'm adapting that over into measurable technologies, tangibles. Been one of my leading projects to get this biokinetic feedback that you can every so often catch just that little spark across. Every so often. Under actual measured quote unquote, it wouldn't be an experiment. It would be welcome to my isolation systems. You know. I don't have a name for it. The scientific process I follow is not based on a theory of what I think will happen. It's based on isolating the variables and constants and their interactions. So what you get are the constants that don't change but do create variations, and variables. It's like saying, hey, what's a good example? Instead of, like, saying, I think this is what will blah, blah, blah. This is, like, let's go through every frequency band and cancel out the harmonic resonance on a, you know, 2 centimeter square tile by 1 by like by 1 millimeter thick. Try that. And then based what the standards are, see variables and constants there. I'm trying to find an example, and based upon that 2 centimeter square tile that's 1 millimeter thick, those are your constants established. So all the interactions to that tile are based upon those measurements and the material, rather than a hypothesis of, I think this will happen. If I have a piece that transmits, and if I have a piece that acts as like a lens, and I put so much power through it of a given wave modulant, what's the modern equivalent in physics? A laser. Laser. Then the laser becomes the constant, and the lenses become variables. The transmitter is one constant. It's a variable constant technically, because it's based upon the laser. So the energy, you know, that's like if I were to take it down into electronics, then it would be like Ohm's law is an isolation of variables and constants. It's called algebra. I wrote it up so nicely, I'm glad I still have a copy of it. This article I wrote for Reddit on the concept, actually a nice, you know, about a page and a half long, on a new scientific method regarding isolation of variables and constants. So, you know, the nature of something and its properties and its interactions, that's what, with other constants, in other words, which goes down into everything. I found out there's actually something called singularity mathematics, and it's a little bit, it's, I understand where they're, what they're doing, because they have to replace the formula for a dot with the cosine system, and that math is shoddy at best, because there you have it, the actual cosine function is a variable constant, and it changes any other variables or constants added into its equation effectively, so it'll always taint the math in the end. You'll get what is known as artifact. That's like if someone didn't know I had seizures, and they were trying to see if coffee was making me jittery or talk a lot or something. They're trying to deduce this, right? But they didn't realize I have seizures, and that directly in front of me during the day, this is the way cars come in. Every last car light on in the day or night, overcast or sunny. I've actually found less cars actually have their lights on in overcast, ironically. I think their light sensors are backwards or something. But there I go, you know, guessing. That's more of an educated guess. But see, I don't know all the variables on that either. Maybe the lights are canceling out each other. And that's what's causing the entire interaction to turn on the light sensor in the first place. Because they're DC, they're pulse lighting. So every so often you're going to get the perfect pulse that cancels out or amplifies. Which will cause, you know, strange lighting things like that to occur in general. That's just with a simple lens and using the edge of a light. Yeah, see the edge of light in the background here. Just coming right along the edge of it. Now it creates this little afterglow. Yeah. would cause the dimmers on a car to not know what the fuck is going on, really. They're on like that all day. And night. It's lights, but wave hello to YouTube. Idiot. They're locked to their perceptions. Be careful if I don't shatter the box they live in their head in and shred it to bits. That would be worse than me shattering their lenses of perception. Kicking down the doors? Or should I just spin a table on you? Maybe it's too many cultural cliches in one sentence. I found that there's a major communication problem. Especially with my body language, even. Primarily with, yes, unfortunately, yes, a touchy yes subject, but it's a cultural upbringing thing, is what I'm thinking. Because, unfortunately, Puritan-type cultures that are conformist in nature tell people how to act and train them from infancy. That means their entire culture is artificial by definition. Born of the mind and blinded by the eyes of the mind. So then your eyes can't actually see nothing outside of that cultural consolidation, otherwise known as a lens. And thus is why I call the whole subject matter a mental illness. Conformity exists in every ethnicity, okay, and creed. It exists. Even the most open source societies, cultures, ethnicities, civilizations still had a common medium. You know, at least a standard where people could all have neutral, a neutral ground, basically. This is why I've been calling, you know, this whole thing, like, hey, America is a free speech platform. And if I'm going to take the extremes of logic and basically stretch them out like they're here, you kid and you kid, hold this rubber band and go run opposite directions. Until the rubber band snaps is the type of logic exemplification I've been giving, as well as super colliding it. Because I'm going by the principle that the extremes of a logic will reveal its frailty. Because not all logic is equal either. Shit. It's like ask a fucking mechanical meat processor. You know, where it mechanically separates the meat from the bone. If it gives a fuck about anything else, I'll end up separating the meat from the bone. Form and function. Since I've been doing the shit live and babying this damn battery back up to like literally 75% I managed to get up to. You know how long it took me? 3 fucking days. Sitting out here for over an hour at a time. Just babying the damn thing up. Got a dent in the cell, so as soon as it hits that point, it starts going gone. Just shorts it out technically inside the cell, so it's already like a accident waiting to happen. Keep gearing everything up for replacements, and then I basically get like rainy days for days, and then I have to turn around and use the money that I set aside to go purchase, like, you know, like, update phone or purchase fucking up, you know, replace a battery. I upgraded the memory when I had extra money. It's got a 32 gigabyte motherfucking SD card in it now. But technically, and that costs more than the battery. But every time I go to fucking get that done, I get these very skies. Like this. Like I'm in someone else's hell. See, this is what I have to deal with all day, these lights. All day. See, I was lucky to have this 3 months. I still have to actually upload some of those videos. I haven't had a chance. Videos are big and they eat up all of my data. And with the lobbies, majority of them still kind of being half shut that I would even be able to go to. And the fact that the lobbies I would go to have giant windows now instead of low windows. Some shaders. That blocks out the sunshine and all that shit so you're not sitting in a disco club while you're trying to eat. And as an epileptic, I notice that shit in about less than 20 minutes. And then I gotta sit there and basically regulate my pH level with this, and if I find fucking a little El Rocho, some El Meriano, El Strano Triste, then I'm good. That's like, I just literally found a little piece of crumb one out here, and it worked better than the whole blunt that I, half a blunt I found on the railroad tracks earlier. Instant relief. I don't know where this proper medicine grade weed I need is, but it's not funny. That's like holding out on someone who does have a life-threatening neurological problem, neurological condition like I do. That is life-threatening. That's holding out on an epileptic. That's, if I had actually known the person, actually been, like, if I actually knew the person, and they wanted to, like, basically use my medicine like you carry it on a stick, manslaughter. Voluntary manslaughter. Which is why I need to get to that damn neurologist, and also means I gotta get that stupid bracelet, which is supposed to happen back in August. Instead, I get that phone call, as I said, on Friday for something that was already handled in June. I'm ready to just head south or leave the country altogether once and for all, because I can already prove the incompetency here. I've had to fix too many errors. I was just speaking about it yesterday out here. That, you know, once compound errors over and over and over again, and I prove that I've had to fix them, that I'm not the one making the errors, and it's the reason I'm out here, that's when people, you know, you go for restitution and grievances. So, you know, refusing to shut up when I'm demanding to talk to Homeland Security about stolen scientific research that's led to the background of my family gone. Or I can just do nothing and wait till, you know, China starts hitting people with ultrasonic weaponry. Throw a sonar condenser ionized, you know, etc. Like I said, DARPA, eat your heart out with a spoon. Ultrasonic technology, like a U-bomb. It's like hitting the resonant frequency of petrol. hydrocarbons. The shatter point. Luckily, the ape freaks are still just super colliding protons. They haven't even tried to crack an egg yet. That's like hitting the oxygen in the air's shattering temperature. And suddenly all the oxygen just suddenly dissipates into a fucking static plasma field. And condenses pretty much all into one single location. Really fast, creating a vacuum in the atmosphere. Everything dies out in a flash before the oxygen levels redistribute. That kind of technology, that kind of shit on paper, that kind of shit and the math, that kind of shit and prototyping, and that kind of shit and proofing concepts. You can kill me, it's not, I'm not responsible no more, and it got stolen from me. Because I was going to provide for my family with it. Go to space. Most of that shit's actually for, like, mining asteroids. Or hollowing out planets. Like, next level shit. Not a bunch of wing nuts that want to play King of the Hill on a molten shit ball. They call a planet. If they only knew there were a dime a dozen. Which leads me back to the fact that I don't know what else to do with the system other than I've already proven that they're incompetent on paper. Well, they proved it. That's what's worse. And this kind of body language not understood in America. Not in all parts. Depends on, once again, that ethnic today, or culture today, or, you know, conformity level, or hell, even awareness level. That's like, you know, you got a headlight out, driver's side. That doesn't freak you out enough. There could be big problem behind this eyeball. It could be cancer. Repeated inflammation leading to brain damage and cellular breakdown. And repairs over and over and over. Shoddy repairs at that. Not good. My eyes are actually trying to literally look away from the lights out there. Instinctive on their own. It's not good. So other than what's been brought to my table, I've just finished compiling and shredding 4 years, 5 years of data. Yeah. See, I don't live for the experience, I just note it. That's what makes me fundamentally different. You know, that's not on purpose. Well, it is. It's intentional, it's natural, is it by choice? I never understood the experience. I actually ran into some wing nuts in Slovenia on that matter. It's about as bad as the fucking wing nuts the jerk off cult in this bitch. Phallus worker. Like, bitch. Your dick is. If your own dick is a turn off.
be a little gay.
In love, from my cultural perspective, when some girl asked me one time, she was saying, why don't you play with your... I said, that's the woman's job. It's all been injury and insult. That's why I basically, for, it's not even, you know, I'm not going to sit there and have third parties fucking sit there and be like, oh, it must be a mood swing. It must be. No, it's more or less, none of you are responsible. This is where I'm already at. There's nothing you can do about it. So mind your own business on the matter. Because it's international heat on me, you know, you could... that's why I state the shit that I do officially. You can help me with what I have requested officially. Coffee, food, medicine. As far as shelter is concerned, I know how to build my own. Location, location, location is... I've been looking. And I could still even double back all the way to the campsite and try to build over there. It's redundant, because this is what it's been. This is literally how it's been. Get everything fixed, and then one retard thinks it's an error, even though I just got done spending 3 months fixing the error. To make sure I even get disability in the first place for these seizures. As you can see, the lights flashing in my face at this point from the traffic. Those are cars passing by. At 90 degrees. Damn. Makes me wish I was a little kid again that they thought I had anger issues because I would break TV sets. It's like he's wishing any type of aggression. Some type of mood problem. That's made up. Aggression comes from the root of aggression is normally either a psychoaptic, which means of the mind, as in I offended your ego, and you're gonna get angry about it. I shattered your ego, now you got nothing to say. Boo hoo. Nextly, the psi emotional consolidation, which goes just into people who live not into the mind, but in their emotional states that they don't even know that no single emotional state is stability. It's all spectrum. What light you shine can be retroactive, as in a response, or it can be proactive, like being the change you want to see, and let it radiate out. That's the empathic side of the argument. Thirdly, is physical response. The actual physical response to pain. Then you have those who recoil, those who strike back. If you actually hit my pain threshold like these seizures do, I'll show you what one feels like with one punch. Actually, more like one open side palm strike so fucking fast. You're gonna wanna fucking record it with a goddamn motherfucking one of those fucking speed cameras to even catch it. That's why I wish I was just a little kid that didn't know to just bite the bullet on ouch, 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 and, you know, leave the room. I used to try. That's why the babysitter got thrown into the fucking TV. Because she made me sit there in front of the TV, and it was hurting my eyes. And I have an aggressive pain response. So if you didn't know those variables and we're trying to, like, you know, deduce anything from a third-party observer effect, it would epic fail, wasting your time. That's when I can go ahead and tell America, you're pretty much 90% not qualified to even try to deduce what the hell I was doing, because I was telling you in the first place. I set the bounds and even went for you to go, like, that's what the safety zone is. That's the safety zone. Everything's a fucking open nerve right now. I'm already up to here on aggressive pain response that I just bite the bullet on. Okay, I'm an adult. As much as I wish I could just be in my impulsive reaction response to these lights, is to throw the first fucking hard object at them. Or to kick it. Or to break it. So, you know, military code of conduct, and I'm sitting here looking at your lights on in the middle of the day as a weapon. How shall I retaliate? How shall I return fire? Anyway, that's 32 minutes on a basic recap. I've been trying to get with my buddy to do the fucking podcast. There's another reason why I don't want to do a full fucking, you know, 20-minute segment system here. I'm doing full rehash of subject matter, so it's already there. And they can be expanded upon as the next little mini-series. This is the shit I'm actively working on. So stay out of my business.